I've always had in the back of my head, it would be really neat to be able to have sex on the electric bull. I mean, come on, what's more exciting than that, right?
I knew it was gonna be a bad idea right from the beginning, but I went along with it.
This is so hot!
I just thought it would be fun for us to sit on the bowl together on a very low setting.
I finally get to fulfill my after-work fantasy.
Just, you know, to get that movement going. Ooh. So we're on the bowl and we're having intercourse. It's slow, romantic, sensual, sexual, and then boom! I am getting electrocuted via vagina.
Whoa, did you feel that?
I had no idea why this bull would be electrocuting me.
Maybe it has a short or something.
All of a sudden, the bull gives us that.
One big final bump in.
Both of us go flying. I land on the floor here, he lands on the floor there. I'm yelling at that point, what's happening? What do I do? The pain, I can't even describe to you.
Darren?
I go over to him.
Darren, are you okay?
Trying to see what to do, to assess him, to help him. I thought he was having a seizure. It went from, I'm getting electrocuted through my vagina, to, oh my God, now Darren's having a seizure.
Darren.
As soon as I touch him, I felt like another little zap. That's when I realized the electricity is coming from him and not the bull.
Call 911.
911, yes.
I didn't go into specifics with the 911 operator. I just basically said, something's wrong with my friend. I think he's having a seizure. Because that's what it looked like.
Get my med bag.
I was in a lot of pain. I was doubled over. My vagina felt like it had been burned. And I run, I get the bag, I open it up, and I am not exaggerating. 20 to 30 bottles of pills, prescription pill bottles. There's definitely something he has never told me about.
Yeah.
Hydro.
No. Red bottle.
I'm trying to tell her what medications to give me, and as she's handing me the bottles, I'm opening up, and at that time, I get shocked.
Pills everywhere. So finally, the paramedics arrive.
Over here!
Honestly, I think that at first glance, they thought that maybe it was like, had something to do with drugs.
This is not what it looks like.
It looked like we were partying on a whole other level.
My boss is going to kill me. Like, seriously dead.
And you have to understand, this is still my place of employment. I'm supposed to be closing up shop, cleaning the place up, and leaving.
Sir, can you tell me your name?
Darren.
Okay, Darren. I'm gonna take care of you now. I'm gonna look at your vitals, okay?
I wouldn't do that!
Stop!
No!
I just remember hearing that the paramedics got a zap.
Call HQ! Tell him we got a... I don't know what. I think this guy's giving off electric shocks.
I'm at the ER because I wanted to fulfill my fantasy of having sex on an electric bull, and something horribly wrong happened.
Your entire pelvic region, including inside your vagina, is covered in burns. Electrical burns.
We had sex on an electric bull, and we both got an electric shock.
He's coming too.
Lisa!
Welcome back, Darren.
Where's Lisa? Oh, she's over here. She's doing good. Please, please.
Okay, buddy.
Where's Lisa?
All right. There we go. There we go. Can I ask, what is the scar on your chest?
Hemochromatosis, defibrillator.
Hemochromatosis is a condition where your body absorbs too much iron, and that iron gets deposited in your vital organs and can cause damage. So in this case, it's the heart that got damaged, and it caused him to have an abnormal rhythm.
Because of this, in my case, my heart was destroyed, which requires me to have a defibrillator in my chest.
When did you last have your defibrillator replaced?
A couple weeks.
So an ICD is an implantable cardioverter defibrillator. And what it does is basically you implant it under the skin and it constantly monitors a patient's heart rate and rhythm.
When Darren's heart rate rises above a certain level, say 150, the defibrillator kicks in and sends a shock to reset his heart rate.
There are many different reasons why someone would need an ICD. Sometimes a patient's heart's really large and it doesn't pump well enough and you're at risk of going into cardiac arrest. So you could go into an abnormal rhythm on your own, you don't know it, and you could just die all of a sudden. So those patients actually need to have a defibrillator put in so that if for some reason their heart goes into a very dangerous, life-threatening rhythm, it will shock them back to normal. There are other reasons people can have mechanical issues with the heart where they go into an abnormal rhythm because of structural issues, or some medications can damage the heart and it just doesn't work properly like a normal heart would. So they need a defibrillator just in case they go into an abnormal rhythm and we need to get them back to a normal rhythm so that they don't die.
But defibrillator batteries don't last forever, and when the batteries die, we replace the old device.
Well, the new one shouldn't have any problems, right?
Well, you'd think, but the new defibrillator isn't always properly calibrated to the patient's heart rate. And if it's too low, it can go off even if the patient's heart isn't at a dangerously high rate.
Come to find out later on that my heart could have been beating just 120 beats a minute and I would have got shocked.
So that's why the shocks are coming from Darren and not the bull.
Of course, having sex on a bull and my heart was going a bit more than 120 beats a minute.
We need to set his defibrillator at a better level where it won't kick in every time his heart rate rises.
That's it?
I want to keep you overnight for observation, but yeah, that should be it.
Yeah, but what about Lisa? Is she gonna be okay?
A burn to the vaginal wall or the vaginal area is like any other burn, but it's gonna be more painful and it may take a little bit longer to heal because it's a mucosal membrane. So you have to make sure you don't engage in any sexual intercourse, because that's just gonna exacerbate your pain and your healing time.
And as far as me, there was really a whole lot they could do to treat my burns. They told me to do like cold compresses, no sexual activity for 2 weeks. I pretty much just had to heal.
Just really wanted to have a fun romantic night with you. A start to a new relationship. And I ruined it.
Even though I just fulfilled a fantasy and there's a possibility of me, you know, dying, I knew if it was gonna go, I didn't have a stranger with me. I had a very good friend.